right? After finishing calculus, now we are left with three chapters. That is about vectors are 3D, both are same. Theory, problems, formula, getting answer, everything is same. In IJK, either here or here, okay. IJK notations only. And the next probability. After that functions, these three chapters left over here, reason that dry chapters and then no guarantee in the exam. Okay. No guarantee in the sense, you cannot attempt in the beginning. That is what I kept these three things in the end of the course. Hence, we will do them. By chance you get easy question and you get correct answer, bonus only. So don't hope that you are scoring marks in these three chapters. Except these three you can score anywhere. Hence that is the reason we are going to start the vectors 3D. That is the easy and already you know basics from physics. Hence, we will continue that chapter furthermore. Some mathematical problems. In that connection, basics in what way you have got from physics, same will continue. Definition all the time, not writing. Define vector, scalar, give example, that is not important. We will go for some other basics which are not from the physics concept. Therefore, we start with very thing, simple things are that generally vector algebra is related to geometry. We need geometry concepts. Distance formula, straight line, perpendicular form, like that. So for that, types of triangles, area, everything we know. Here what is first? Directed line segment. Basic definitions only. Only for information, not that you will get these things in the exam. Directed line segment. You take one line where ends are unknown. When the ends are unknown, what is meaning? Starting, ending is not there. Going so on indefinitely. Call a ray. Generally physics a light ray, like that. If you can put the limits here, what is meaning of limits? Starting point, ending point. Starting point, ending point is general English, not in mathematics and not in this chapter. Okay. Initial point, terminal point is correct. Therefore, IPTV, a line with initial point, terminal point, both are known. Initial, starting, ending. It shows that it is going through A towards B, hence direction on a line. One part of the total line, segment. Segment means some piece in a straight line with direction. That is a directed line segment. Total vector algebra we strictly depend on directions. Initial, terminal, compulsory. That is the reason this is very simple information which is missing in POC. Not there, but we need all this. Whatever things are missing and covering here, so you get idea. So called directed line segment. In this case, we can mention the vector. How we can mention this vector as A, B? A to B, arrow. Usually in question paper, they will put directions. Sometimes they will not put. That means why you have no confusion. With or without, no problem. AB bar. If you take B to A, arrow will be reverse. Then B becomes initial, A is terminal, hence BA. So the reason is like this. This is called directed. Then Next, simple simple definitions. That is, suppose if you consider like vectors. Negative vectors equal vectors okay next parallel vectors all concept like vector means what is meaning that two vectors in the same direction, same magnitude, suppose this is like this, this is also exactly same, direction is same, magnitude is same, whereas directions are opposite. Magnitudes not necessarily same. Which are in opposite direction. Magnitudes are same. Compulsory you should take that. Equal and opposite. Okay. Equal magnitude. Opposite direction. Equal magnitude. Suppose same length, but opposite, small difference, direction. Okay, equal vectors, two vectors of same magnitude, direction is not important, opposite direction, same direction, but magnitudes are same only, like this. Either opposite, equal. Equal in the sense it is distance is equal, length is equal. AB 5 kilometers, BQ 5 kilometers, equal. Direction is not important, so equal vectors. Parallel vectors. Now, magnitude is not important. Same direction, or opposite direction, parallel vectors. Very small change in this concept. These are all very simple basics only. You need not to write just for idea. After this, now further it will continue. When the vectors are parallel, what kind of cases possible? So called parallel vectors means A bar comma B bar are any two vectors. We say A bar is parallel to B bar. Same direction. Magnitude can be any one. A bar is equal to scalar multiple of B bar, but lambda of scalar is positive. Because of same direction. Suppose if they are in opposite direction, lambda will be negative. Here same direction not necessarily the same. In this case, it can go in this way also. Same direction parallel. Opposite direction also we have like this. This is also possible. So, positive negative only. If you write one vector is a scalar multiple of other vectors, irrespective of direction, parallel vectors. According to the sign of scalar, we decide directions also. Next. Coinitial vectors having same initial point. AB, AC, camera factor is no problem. Having same initial point. Therefore, here what we say? AB, AC, AD are three co-initial vectors. Reverse them. What is reverse diagram? Initial we don't know. Okay. AP, BP, CP. What is here difference in the first and here? Terminal point is same. Here first vector is the same. Starting is the same. Ending is the same. So called co-terminal. Co-terminal vectors. Vectors having same terminal point called co-terminal. Okay. Collinear is same for parallel. Parallel vectors also we can consider in the case that collinear vectors. We can consider collinear vectors. That is one. Then going on in this case, next section formula. What is that coordinate geometry we know? Internal section, external section. Mx2, Mx1 by M plus N, like that. Plus is internal, minus is external. Suppose AP are two points, whose position vectors A bar? Meaning is distance from origin. OB is B bar. C is any point in between somewhere. C bar whose position? Then C bar is equal to C divides AB in the ratio M is to M. MB bar NA bar by this is called section formula. Since plus means internal, minus is external. Okay, that is therefore, if you cross multiply, when it is cross multiplied, what you will get here? MB bar plus NA bar is equal to R. N A bar, M B bar, plus minus M minus N C bar 0. This is in the form of P A bar, Q B bar, R C bar such that the sum of these scalars is 0. A linear combination. The sum of products of vectors and the scalars is a linear combination. This is called linear combination. Whenever you write scalar multiplication of vector and the scalar, no symbol in between, you cannot put anything. Then that is called linear combination. Sum is zero. Is the theorem called that one vector divides the other two in the section formula, internal. Then, in general, there is one definition called linearly dependent vectors. Independent vectors based on linear combination. With the linear combination only. What is that linear combination here? For any three scalars, L, M, N, A bar, B bar, C bar are the vectors like this. Not all the scalars zero. All of them are not zero. At least one will be non zero. One not over anything number compulsory non zero. Then it is a linearly set of dependent set of vectors. Suppose each scalar is zero. All scalars zero. M is 0, R is 0, therefore 0. Zero number is important. Okay. Here they are scalars. That is why 0. If they are vectors, 0 bar actually. In this case, it is called independent set. So, simple definition. Suddenly they can ask definition itself as one question, ABCD. Hence we are writing. Next. After this, basics in vectors, addition and subtraction of vectors is another one. Scalar multiplication also we know, lambda a bar, parallel vectors. Okay. Next, how to find line equations? Vector equation of line passing through A bar parallel to B bar. See, this is A bar. One vector is given other side, outside. Then what is the line equation? Formula is A bar plus T B bar only. Formula, direct answer only. Further no calculations, nothing. They will mention in A bar, B bar only. If you write this into algebraic notation, so 3D. That is reason both are same. Vector and 3D same only. This is called straight line equation. Well, R, where is that R here? If you assume A means what is meaning? Distance from origin is A distance. P is any point whose position vector is R bar. That is what variable vector. AB is parallel to B bar. When we say two vectors are parallel, what is implying that AP is parallel means T scalar multiple. AP equal. What is position vector of AP here? Terminal minus initial. Hence, therefore, R bar minus A bar means R bar is equal to. That is one line proof, not important. Direct formula only. They will give you A vector, B vector, answer. Complete answer. Next. They will ask you this in terms of Cartesian form. Assume that R bar is x, y, y, z, z, k, x, y, z. A bar is a1, 2, 3. A1, 2, 3. B bar, b1, 2, 3. Then we know direct Cartesian form. Means geometry. Without I, j, k, if you write, that is called Cartesian form. X minus A1 by B1, Y minus A2 by B2, Z minus A3 by B3. In 3D, the denominators, this part we will consider direction ratios, direction cosines are extra. That is nothing is different. So all are almost same. Then this is called line in vector notation. In geometry means Cartesian. Cartesian represents geometry. Cartesian coordinate geometry, actually. Nowadays nobody will write in the textbook Cartesian. Name of the vehicular started doing geometry. Cartesian is name of the person, therefore. Actually, Cartesian coordinate geometry must be there. Sometimes, suddenly, in some papers, are also. If xyz denote coordinates in Cartesian plane, suddenly they will announce it. You must be ready. That is my reference. Cartesian means geometric form. This is about line. Suppose if it is passing through origin. Origin is here. Means if line passes through origin. Origin means three coordinates. Two coordinates is x, y, x axis, y axis, geometry. Here three, x, y, z. Where is z? Projected in the space. Projected. X axis, y axis. This is z axis. Z Select any point. Distance. 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 3. That is why 3-dimensional. 3D. I take notation. Hence, if A bar is 0, AP, OA is 0, then what is the answer? R equal to TB, which is in straight lines passing through origin, slope is M, Y equal to MX. Okay, Y equal to MX form. This is Y equal to MX plus C form, like that. So it is. Instead of parallel vector, next line passing through two points, means two vectors. Two point form. R bar is 1 minus T A bar plus T B bar, where T is a scalar only. Okay. That is. Then Cartesian form as well, again if you write here A bar plus T comma B minus A. Same components you take A 1 2 3 B 1 2 3. What is Cartesian form here? X minus A1 by B1 minus A1. Next is A. Y minus A2. B2 A2. Z minus A3. B3 A3. Like that we have. So called line of 2-point form. In statements we have 2-point form. Here it is in vector or Cartesian form. That is about line journey 2 points. Then next coplanar, co-initial, co-linear. What is that co here component? Co-linear. Co-initial. Co-planar. On the same line, collinear. Having same initial, co-initial. In the same plane, co-planar. Same co-company. Okay? That is what? Co-planar means what? You take one any plane, no? 3 points belong to same. No? Co-planar. Minimum 3. That is the reason we have property. To determine one plane, no? We need at least 3 points. To draw a line, 2 points. For a circle, we need 3 points. In plane, we need 3 points. Every 3 non-collinear points, they are not on the same line. We are not having like this. Hence, property here, first definition we see was coplanar. It is there applicable in POC also. Three vectors belong to same plane are called coplanar. Okay. What is that definition says here? Property. If you want to draw any plane, suppose this board is a plane only. How you can put the board here? 4 points are there on the wall, fixing. So more than 3 only. Every surface is one plane. Duster. This is one plane surface. Actual speaking, plane surface means plane. Hence, if you take 3 points, definitely they are like this. Here, 3 vectors also non-collinear. 3 non-collinear vectors are coplanar. Any 3 non-collinear gives one plane. Whereas collinear vectors, infinite planes. More than 3 you can draw. That is the reason non-collinear interest, they will determine one plane, coplanar. Generally plane is denoted by symbol is pi. Either here are vectors stating pi represents plane. It is not of any value like 180 degrees or 22/7. Like set theory, universal set theory, then that here it is pi. So it belongs to same plane, coplanar. Next, how to find that plane equation? Right? that is already we have. R dot n equal to p. What is this represents? Plane passing through a plane whose normal vector is r bar. Distance from origin. Suppose this is origin. Z axis normal space we cannot put, hence we should give like this. X, Y, Z. One plane we have. Like this plane, distance from origin, perpendicular distance, n bar. Right? P is any point. So, perpendicular distance is P, unit normal vector. Normal means perpendicular to plane. This is plane only. For this, you put like this. Here. Anywhere you put. Pen is perpendicular to duster. Where is that? Not important. Anywhere you can put. Then we can say it is normal. If you consider only one particular line, one particular perpendicular, that is called perpendicular. It refers to one line to one line, line to line. That is why it is called actually perpo. Okay. Greek language actually name is perpo. Later development, since you are giving perpendicular, you are giving right angle line to a line only, that is why perpendicular line. That is the meaning. It refers line only. A perpendicular is enough. But here what is happening? This is perpendicular to line. Instead of line, this is perpendicular to plane surface. Total surface. Then we say it is normal. That is the reason. Normal has more importance in this chapter. Either you say vectors are 3D or both are same, in physics or everywhere you have got normal. Normal to the surface meaning is, it is perpendicular to every line of the plane. Suppose I say that pen is perpendicular to board. Total board perpendicular only, anywhere. You put all the lines like anywhere on the board, any line you put. For that given that line, this is perpendicular. Then entirely perpendicular to surface. Normal refers to a surface. Perpendicular refers to single line. That is the reason this is called normal form of the plane. In geometry we know. Suppose if I start with x, y, z, n bar, l, m, n, I get it. P anyway. Dot product, x I, y j, z k means, what is that normal form of the line we have? X cos alpha, y sin alpha, z is extra. Take as normal form. So called plane equation. Next. How we have got suddenly in between I, j, k notations, why we can consider, which is the same as the vectors or 3D, what is reason? Because we can have one three-dimensional view, three-dimensional figure, three dimensions, x, y, z. That is the reason we have to go for three dimensions. What is that? See, suppose, consider, a parallel pipette. Okay. X, Y, Z. Where P is point in this space. It is not from planes, not on x-axis, y-axis. It is in the space. like fan is suspended in the room, which is in the space only. Okay, so called P. Based on that, if you finish the parallelepiped or else cuboid, we call it as parallelepiped, where both is diagonal of the room. One classroom is like that. Okay, then faces are parallelograms. Faces are parallelograms. X-axis A, Y-axis B, Z-axis C. Other points you can consider M, S, anything you can get, no problem. This is about parallelepiped means parallelograms. Okay. Well, OP distance is R units. P coordinate because XYZ neither in planes. Therefore, XYZ. Very good. We need unit vector. What is meaning of unit vector? Magnitude 1. Magnitude 1. Unit vector. Then, how to represent the notation for unit vector? E bar. The throughout syllabus, hereafter, E bar represents unit vector. Okay. Then, how to obtain unit vector for any given? If A bar is any vector, divide with magnitude. That is the reason it becomes every vector by its magnitude. Unit vector. Okay. E bar. Here we have a fixed notations on the coordinate axis. There are ijk is one cyclic order. I bar, j bar, k bar are the three unit vectors lie on perpendicular lines x, y, z. That is why this is called orthogonal unit vector triad. OUVT. Understood the standard notation. Here after every time we will not tell what is the ijk. Understood they are unit vectors. Orthogonal. What is meaning perpendicular? In two dimensional perpendicular, in three dimensional it becomes orthogonal. So in three dimensional generally perpendicular is not a correct terminology, correct word. That is the reason orthogonal. Magnitude is one unit, therefore unit vectors. Three vectors we are taking at a time. That is why orthogonal unit vector triad. Then the position vector of P can be written as xi plus yj zk. Then that is how you can find the length of the vector OP. Magnitude is root of sum of the squares of components, ijk components. Sum of the squares is what? Xi, yj, zk. Therefore, in general, suppose if you take one vector OP, if I give you 3i, 2j, k, what is its magnitude? 13. Root 13. Hereafter, any time when we want magnitude of vector in ijk, you have to write sum of the squares. Sometimes I will not write ijk, understood the numbers in the bracket. Question paper also, suddenly they will write triplet, number. Three numbers in the bracket. Therefore, ijk order. No question of changing the direction. I will change I, next k, j, I want to write i, k, j, j, k, impossible. Fix it. So called, every vector will be represented in terms of ijk. Here, why we have got these things? Since there is one indirect theory, if you take this space, floor, parallelogram, where we know OA is XI, this is ZK. In general, parallelogram law of addition. What is parallelogram law of addition of vectors? தரலக்கணும் டாப் எடிஷன் ஆஃப் வெக்டர்ஸ் இனி நீ தரலக்கணும் சப்போஸ் இஃப் யூ நோ டூ எடிஷன் சைட்ஸ் ஏ பார் பி பார் இம்மிடியட்லி டயாகனல் இஸ் பாசிபிள் சம் ஆஃப் தெம் ஏ பிளஸ் பி ஏ பிளஸ் பி ரிப்ரசன்ஸ் ஒன் டயாகனல் ஏ மைனஸ் பி ரிப்ரசன்ஸ் அதர் டயாகனல் வெரி குட் இட் சேஸ் தட் எடிஷன் ஆஃப் வெக்டர்ஸ் இஸ் டிஃபைன்ட் by geometrical meaning that is the reason so called parallelogram law of addition addition does not say only s plus sign minus also addition only but here minus b is opposite vector so remember as a result our property in any parallelogram sum of any two sides adjacent any two adjacent sides gives diagonal difference other diagonal so called parallelogram law of addition before that what is triangular law of addition triangular law of addition of vectors if you take any two sides you will get third side ab plus bc is equal to ac initial terminal equal same Then the result will be first and first point is last point. This is because it is in the triangle. Therefore, it is called triangular law of addition. We can add any number of vectors in with condition. Initial point here is same for terminal point. Chain continuum. In that way, suppose if there is a vector AB, BC. CD. What is the answer? AB. Initial terminal. Where is it? Another simple question. AB, BC, CD, DA. Then what is it? AA. Both are same. Coincide. No distance. Length zero. Zero vector. Therefore, this is called zero bar. When both are same. Means null vector. Zero only scalar, zero bar, zero vector. In some question paper, some textbook, dark light they will write, but writing on paper probably not possible. Hence, bar must be there. That is called symbol for vector notation. Anyway, we know that the vectors in terms of i, j, k same. If you write one line extra, 3D only. If this line makes angles with x-axis alpha, y-axis beta, z-axis gamma. If OP makes angles alpha, beta, gamma, then their cosine values, what is meaning? Cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma are called direction cosines. That much only extra, which is in 3D. This is that direction cosines are denoted by LEM and such that therefore sum of these squares definitely will be one identity. What is meaning? From trigonometry also there is one problem. Sum must be one when cos alpha beta gamma are this is. He is giving one question in the exam earlier also in the paper. What is value of sin square with sin square or sin square or sin square? What is the answer for this? They will ask you definitely. You write answer is 2. Why? Why 2? We know that standard result. If cos alpha beta gamma are direction cosines, sum must be 1. Write this in terms of cos. 1 minus cos square, 1 minus cos square, 1 minus cos square. What is implied? 3 minus half cos square, 1, that is 1. Simple problem, one of them is not. All exam papers, previous material, everywhere. Easy to find. Okay, it is from direction cosines. What are the direction ratios of the, if they ask? Divide with value. These are the components here. This is our magnitude. Okay. these xyz components are called drs, divide with them op becomes dc's, direction ratios, direction numbers. Components are called, what are the components here? Example 3 comma 2 comma 1. Distances along xyz are the numbers. Distance, that means magnitude value only, numbers. Along the direction from origin only, direction numbers. Later it becomes direction ratios. Hence, we are using drs, components of any vector, drs. How to convert drs into dc's? Divide with its magnitude. Op is there, that means in this example, 3 by root 13, 2 by root, 1 by root, are the direction cosines. Any problem, direction cosines, definitely you have to get 1, otherwise they are not direction cosines. Take the sum of the squares, compulsory, you will get 1. This is called extra. What is extra in the IJK notations, vectors to 3D? DRs, DCs, is extra vector. Okay, both are same. Then, like triangular operation, addition of vectors in parallelogram, so called in general addition. Based on that, parallel vector. Faces are parallelograms. If faces are squares, cuboid. Parallel biped. Don't think just for textbook print, therefore we are writing parallel biped. In geometry, you draw square. This is a cube. You draw square. What is difference? Two dimensional, three dimensional. Any geometrical figure taken to three dimensional figure. In the class also I told so many times. Okay. Other things. How to notice it is 2D or 3D? Suddenly. Any title in 2D, end with ED. It is come under 3D. Okay. Parallelogram. But it is parallel hyper. What is that confusion unnecessary time is spent? ED is there at the end. Cuboid, conchoid, cylindroid, spheroid, parallelepiped. They are called three-dimensional figures. That is the simple difference. So called three-dimensional tactics. Ends with ED. Any geometry figure you write. Other things, because we don't discuss in syllabus, so you don't know the difference. Actually, we have earlier. Conchoid, spheroid, cuboid, cylindroid, everything is there. You will get these things in future again by mistake. If you go for engineering, you will get all this again in the real analysis, calculus, applications. You have to find volume of spheroid, cuboid, everything. Conchoid, everything. Then you will go for integration, double integral, triple integral. Many things are there. That is okay. Anyway, it is purely related to science, scientific. Vector theory is purely from science, physics on the background. Mainly it is for physics. So, in this connection, we know all vectors will be in IJK notation. So far, we have got basics, some definitions we have to, differences I give, results, section formula, linear combination, dependent vectors. Independent vectors, parallel vectors, then IJK notations, okay, then line equation, plane equation, first level this is, not easy in the exam, this will give more confusion that whether answer right or wrong, how to start, where you will start, it is not easy to decide, but practice, whereas next year it will be easy for you, that, what is that? What is this? Both are multiplications only. Both are multiplication. No? Where you will do? In your general era, general algebra, 3 into 4 is 12. 3 into 4 is 12. In real numbers, algebra, not a problem. In vector algebra, both are opposite, east and west. Completely different. okay, symbolic form itself is very different here. Since there is a dot, therefore dot product. Since there is a cross, therefore cross product. Both are different chapters. Exclusively for physics equation. Many things will be there in physics. Work done. When force is given, if an external force is applied on an object which is placed at P, then the object is moving, or object changes its place, so means displacement. What is the work done? F dot, yes, dot, but not cross. What is that term? F dot, yes, scalar. Force is vector. Examples already we know. Velocity, acceleration, force, momentum, stress, but not strain, but scalar. Scalars are many things. Length, area, distance, heat, temperature. All are vectors, scalars. Scalar quantity, here vector quantities. Two vector quantities having this symbol, result go to scalar. That is why original name of this chapter is called the scalar product, because result is scalar. If you get result is again a vector, and then that is called vector product, symbol is cross. Dot product, scalar product. Cross product, vector product. Both we have to independent chapters, their results, applications, properties, and then how to do problems. After finishing this, there is one more last unit which is not in PUC, combine them. Third chapter is there. It is not that much given in PUC, but very important in entrance exam. That is combination of both dot comma cross. Both together we are writing. Triple product. Three vectors how to multiply. Okay. That is last unit. Easy to score in exam. If you get problems related to dot, cross, triple product, you will get definitely answers. Whereas previous first part what we got so far not easy. Hence this is a scoring. So next class we are going for this properties, definition, applications, examples, both, and then combine this one. Conclusion, here one problem given previous back in CET, this problems. Here we have got three standard problems, one every year they are rotating. We are writing all these three. Okay. This is conclusion. We will do our vector training. After finishing, what is next left over? We have got functions probability. That is why I left these three at the end. After no guarantee, however you do. If you get answers, bonus. Right? So next class we will finish the remaining concept and then slowly we will start problems doing. It is a slow process, not very quick like integration.